If you're looking for the answer for your website, when do you have copyright on your website? Just break it down. Themes. Did I create the themes? No? Okay, I have a right to use. I have a dream. That's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Hi, welcome. Welcome to this video. In this video, I want to talk about the question, can I copyright my website? This question seems simple. It seems obvious. But if you look at the back end, or if you look at a lot of situation, you will see that you need to look at the part of the website. So in this video, we're going to talk about, can I copyright my website? Yeah. So we're going to go to the drawing board, and I'm going to explain to you how the copyright works in the Netherlands, where you can find the rules. And then I'm going to show you, when you look at your website, what do you need to look for in order to come to the conclusion if you have a copyright or not. Simple, right? So what you're going to do right now is we're going to go to the drawing board, and as you can see, this is a drawing board, and the question is, can I copyright my website? First thing was copyright. In order for you to explain how you can find these rules, so just look at them up. Here you see the official text of copyright in the Dutch Kingdom, and here you see the translation. Simple, right? So in order for you to explain also what exclusive right is of the author, work, and exclusive right is the way to make it public and you're allowed to reproduce it, and there are some limitations. I explained that. So what I'm going to explain now is, when you look at the website, there are certain kind of things that you need to keep in mind. So we need to keep this definition in mind. This is the translation of this. That doesn't mean this is the correct translation. Like I explained in another video, when you look at the translation is about making choices. So just use this as a guideline. If you have question about certain kind of things, it's better for you to follow the official text. If you have question about copyright, just go in the Discord, ask me directly, and I will see what I can do for you. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. So first thing first, we have here on a blank paper. We'll discuss some things about website, so you can understand what I'm talking about. So as soon as people look at the website, they only look at the website like, oh, this is what I'm seeing in front. So if I go to Google and I visit the website, I will see the things in front. But what people most of the time forget is, the website has a theme. The website has a source code. Source code is the code in the website to make it work. So people code the website, like WordPress, you have a code behind, and that source code is creating your website and make it functional. Yeah. And besides that, the website also have content. Content like a blog post or a picture or whatever they have. Yeah. And here, if you look at content, we have two things. We have text. So with T for text, and here for other media. Yeah. And besides that, what more do we have when you look at the website? When you look at the website, we have the media, the text, the source code, and I don't remember what this was. But let's keep it up. But when you go to a website, you also have a domain name. So the domain. So let's put here. Thing is, I need to get used to this. Dot. Let's say .org is domain name. Yeah, domain name. So we have content, we have text, media, source code, and I forgot what the T was. Yeah. But when you look at the website, you have a lot of options. Yeah. If you look at copyright says, as soon as you create something and it meets the requirements of copyright, you have copyright. You don't have to register. You don't have to do anything. You have copyright. As soon as you can prove it, you're good to go. What are your rights? Your rights allowed to make it public, and your rights allowed to reproduce it. Yeah. So if you look at the website, as soon as you create the source code, if you meet requirements of copyright, you have copyright on it. As soon as you create a content like the text or put some media on the website, you create a website, a media for the website, you have copyright on it. You put it on a website. Yeah. Domain name, it's hard to get copyright on domain name. But domain name, if you look at domain name, first come, first get. It's that simple. And the thing is, there are some situations where you can get copyright on the domain name, but it's not as strong. It doesn't really help you. The best way to look at domain name is just to get a trademark for it. So if you have a certain kind of name and you already have the domain name, try to register a trademark. We will talk about that in another video. Yeah. So if I look at the question of the day is, can I copyright my website? You see, we have a lot of content on the website. And ask yourself this question. Can I copyright my website? When you look at the website as a whole, you have a lot of different kind of things that you need to put on the website. And when you put all those things together, you have an end product. That end product is your website. And if you look at this question, can I copyright my website? If you are creating everything by yourself, like you're creating the source code, you are creating the content, the media, and the text, and you have domain name or whatever, you can say, hey, I have copyright on it. I'm not saying you need to create everything, but what I'm saying is when you hire someone to create something for you, watch out for the copyright or watch out for the contract that you have with the person. So let's say I hire a copywriter to write daily blogs for blogs, and I pay the person. You need to watch out what you put in the contract between you, so this is me, between me and the copyright. I need to watch out, okay, what do I put in the contract? And what is the license that I have when she or he created a blog post? It's content for my website, but it doesn't mean I have copyright on those things. I need to look at the license. Do they transfer all those things to me? Or do they give me a right to use? You understand what I mean? Okay. So when you create a copywriter, when you create a copywriter to create things for you, you need to ask yourself those things. If you have someone that created a video for you, so let's say a video producer, VP, same story. What is in the contract? And what are the licenses for me? Also with other medias, podcasts or whatever, what is in the license? Because when you look at copyright, when someone has a copyright, they have the rights to make it public and reproduce it, right? So if they create a text, they have copyright on it. They have the right to make it public or reproduce it. As soon as it's on my website, I'm making it public. Do I have that right? That's the question you need to ask yourself. When someone creates a video and you post it on your website, do you have the right to make it public? Do you have the right to copy that video and put it on another website? That's the thing that you need to ask yourself. When someone creates content for your website, those content, you need to ask yourself, what is my license? Do I have a license? What's in my license? When someone creates something for me, do I get the copyright from it? You understand? So if you look at here, as soon as someone creates something and they meet the requirements of copyright, they have copyright. They do not need to register. And if you use it outside the license, you can have a problem. So if you look at the question of today, can I copyright my website? Think about it for a second. If you are creating all of things yourself, you have nothing to worry about because you will meet the requirements and you are the author. But if you're letting someone else create those things for you, you think about, okay, what kind of license do I have with this person, or do I need to let them sign a contract? You understand what I mean? So if you have questions about the license and the contract that you need, just go on the Discord, add me directly, and I will see what I can do for you. But if you're on the Discord, I can help you, and other people can also help you in order to meet to get whatever you want. So can I copyright my website? Yes, you can. But you need to make an overview. What is it that I create myself? If I'm creating this myself, I have copyright on it. But if someone else is creating it, what is my license? Because if you look at the ABC formula, ABC, in this case, copywriter and the video production, or it doesn't matter, the creator, is B, and I am C. I need to have a license in order to use the thing that they create in A. If I don't have a license, it's going to be really difficult. And when I do something and I don't like it, they can come after me. But most of the time, people think just because they do not come after me, nothing happened. But a copywriter or video producer can have a lot of reasons to not come after you. For example, you are a potential client. But it doesn't mean in the future they will not come after you. That's one thing. Another thing is they do not have the resources. But it doesn't mean they will not come after you in the future. You understand? So if you look at the question, can I copyright my website? Yes, you can. But you need to look out, which part of my website do I want to copyright? Do I need to do certain kind of things in order to meet the requirements of copyright? So just look at the requirements of copyright. I explained that in another video. And here you see the requirements of copyright. Just look at it and see, do I meet the requirements? I have copyright on it. As soon as you publish it on your website, you can prove that you have copyright on it. So this question is not that difficult, but it can be complicated if you don't have an overview of what is it that you're creating and what is it that you have. And what you need not to forget, now remember what this T is. This T is for themes. Most websites are made from themes. Like when you create a WordPress website, the WordPress website is created from a theme if you buy a theme. What you try not to forget is the person that created themes has copyright on it. You are just getting a license to use. And when you have a license to use, that means your website is there with the theme, but you're only allowed to use the theme. That doesn't mean you own the theme. So if you look at it, if you create a website from bottom up, from the source code, everything by yourself, it's easy to get copyright. But when you break down a certain kind of websites, you will see that people has a right to use. They do not own the copyright of the website. But if you look at the total picture, if you create everything by yourself, there may be some cases where you'll be like, okay, the total website, you have copyright on it. But you need to meet the requirements of copyright. And it also depends what kind of action you're going to take and in what kind of situation you are. See this question? It can get really difficult, but can also be really simple. If you're looking for the answer for your website, when do you have copyright on your website? Just break it down. Themes. Did I create the themes? No. Okay, I have a right to use. Source code. Did I create the source code? No. I think I have a right to use. Content. Did I create the content myself? No. I think I have a right to use. Or look at my license. What is my license? Media. Same story. Domain name, you can get copyright for it, but that's hard. And if you really want the copyright for that, just try to go for a trademark, like I said before. So copyright can be interesting. And the thing is, it's hard to say if you have a copyright for a website. Seriously, it's hard, but you need to break it down. Break it down. What are those things on my website? Did I create it myself? Yes or no? No. Do I have a license? What is my license? What can I do with it? And if not, try to get a license. So for example, if you need picture for your website, try to get the license for those pictures. There's a lot of websites there where you can get a license for picture. You just pay a small fee and you have those pictures and you can use it for your website. So if you have question about this, can I copyright my website, or you are still confused about this, just go in the Discord, ask me directly, and I'll see what I can do for you. Okay. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be